Amplified Bible says, to the full until it overflows. Glory be to God, abundant life. And he needs us to share this good news with the whole world.
Amen.
See, people need to know that God doesn't want you broke. Amen. God doesn't want you sick. Amen. That's what the devil wants.
Right.
But this verse makes it so simple. If something is life and it's good, it's from God.
Amen.
But if it's death and it's bad, it's from the devil. James 1:17 says every good gift and every perfect gift is from above.
Amen.
And comes down from the Father of light, in whom there is no variableness, neither shadow turning. God ain't going to flip the script on us. Amen?
Amen.
Simply put, good things come from God. Bad things come from the devil.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. God just blames for a lot of stuff that the devil is doing. God has ordained laws for our good, so that we can enjoy the abundant life that he's provided for us, but we have to learn what the laws are, and we have to cooperate with the laws.
Right.
We cooperate with them, number one, by believing. We've heard a lot here about believing. Amen. That's how you cooperate. You got to believe it in your heart, then you have to speak it out of your mouth. Faith has to be in two places. It has to be in your heart, and it has to be coming out of your mouth. Amen?
Amen.
The Bible says that you will have what you say.
Amen.
But a lot of people are saying what they have.
Yep.
But you can have what you say. So why not say what God says?
Yeah, right.
I say I'm blessed, I'm not bragging on me, I'm bragging on God.
That's right.
He says I'm blessed.
Right.
Amen?
Amen.
You can say whatever God says about you. God wants us to prosper and be in health, even as our soul, our mind, our will, and our emotions prosper. We can demand faith to stop stealing, killing, and destroying the blessings that belong to us. You can demand it. You are a child of the Most High God.
Right.
You have authority in the earth. We can use our believer's authority to walk in victory. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah.
In the natural realm, if somebody stole something from us, we have the right to press charges. We have the right to have them arrested and prosecuted if necessary. And if they're found guilty, they can be punished in some way. They may have to go to jail. They may have to pay back what they stole from us. But it all depends on our exercising our rights and pressing charges, right? Amen?
Amen.
Well, it's the same in the spiritual realm. We as believers have God-given rights and privileges. God has established his will for us, but it's up to us to name it and claim it.
Amen.
It's up to us to blab it
and grab
it. Amen.
Yeah, blab
and
grab.
You have to press the issue. You have to take your authority and enforce God's spiritual laws. God is not going to do it. He told us to do it. Amen?
Amen?
But if you don't know what his laws are, if you don't know what his word says, you can't enforce it.
Right.
The devil will beat you. He will have you tore up from the floor when you don't know who you are.
Yeah.
Amen. He'll run your life when you don't know who you are in Christ.
Right. And they're done that.
Many Christians today don't know what belongs to them because of the blood of Jesus. Jesus paid a high price for our salvation, and we need to know what his sacrifice provided for us. Sad to say, some Christians don't read their Bible from one Sunday to the next. They don't even open up their Bible. They don't even know what they have a right to. They want to go to church on Sunday and have the pastor tell them everything that they need to know. Now, we need to receive from the pastor, but more important than that is building an intimate, personal relationship with Jesus Christ yourself. Amen. Amen. I don't want to be like the sons of Caesar, going to try to cast out a devil through the Jesus that pastor preaches about. I got to know Jesus for myself. I got to know that I know that I know. Amen. I got to know him as Jehovah El Elyon, my Most High God. I got to know him as Jehovah Jireh, my provider. I have to know him as Jehovah Rapha, my healer. I got to know him as Jehovah Tsitsenu, my righteousness. I got to know him as Jehovah Roi, my shepherd. I have to know him as Jehovah Shema, my omnipresent God who will never leave me. See, I got to know him for myself. Amen. I got to have that personal, intimate relationship with God for myself. I can't just know him through a pastor. Amen. I have to know him as Adonai, my master. I have to know him as Jehovah, my God. I have to know him as Elohim, my creator. I have to know him for myself. I'm not satisfied with just knowing Jesus through my husband or through my pastor. I gladly receive what they teach me, but I got to know him for myself. Amen. I have to spend time in the Word of God for myself. Just hearing it a few times a week here at church ain't going to get it for me. That might work for some Christians, but it doesn't work for me. Amen. I need more than that. I need all of God that I can get. Amen. This means that I have to discipline myself. I have to discipline myself to spend time with God and His Word. This means not allowing people and things to rob me of my God time.
Amen.
You know, a lot of times when I get ready to go in prayer, the phone will ring.
Oh, yeah.
Or the devil will tell me a whole bunch of things that I need to be doing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but you know what I do? I let the phone ring. And they can do what my voicemail tells them to do. You know, leave your name and number, and I'll get back with you when I can. So I can't be robbed of my God time. Amen?
Amen.
My God time is the most important time of my day. And don't misunderstand me. I commune with God throughout the day. I have to ask His opinion, and we all do. We need to acknowledge Him in all our ways throughout the day. Amen? But I have my special time when I get away from all the busyness, when I get away from the TV and the computer and the phone. That's my God time.
Amen.
And I don't let nobody rob me of that because I need that time. I need to hear from God. He said, my sheep hear my voice.
Amen.
Yeah, I need to know what to do in every situation in my life. I can't trust myself, but I can trust Him.
Amen.
I can trust Him that's in me. Amen? We hear His voice in our quiet time. We hear His voice through His Word. We hear His voice through the precious Holy Spirit. Amen? Our God time is a time for us to be still and know that He is God. By spending time with God and His Word, we discover what is rightfully ours. The abundant life that Jesus came for us to have. Amen. We discover that we don't have to be sick and broke and defeated in this life. Jesus has redeemed us from the curse of the law. Amen.
Amen.
Say, I am redeemed.
I am redeemed.
You're redeemed from the curse. In the same way that the physical world operates under natural laws, God's kingdom operates under spiritual laws. These laws are constant, they are universal, they are established facts. Electricity operates under law. It is an established fact that if you're grounded and grab a live wire, it will kill you. Amen. On the other hand, a bird can land on the wire and not be electrocuted because it's not grounded. There are just laws that govern how things work. The same applies to gravity. If you jump off an extremely high building and hit the pavement, it will kill you. It's a law. Amen. There's a law of electricity and there's a law of gravity. These laws are constant and they're universal. They are the same for everybody, everywhere. They are established facts. It is our responsibility to learn what God's laws are and enforce them in our life. Amen?
Amen.
I said on last week that we are law enforcement.